Well, it's been 5 years. Can't hold back my tears, 'cause I'm just so happy I'm marrying an angel today. Oh, as I take your hand, I pledge to be your man. I vow to love, to hold, to cherish, and never disrespect the love we share. There'll be some bad times. I'll be standing right beside you, my sweet baby, with my love of mine. Oh, and you take this ring and I place it on your sweet, lovely hand. Show our kids, they will tell their kids what mom and daddy did on the day I married my angel. I love you, my angel.
Sweet love. In heaven, we come right now first to say thank you. Thank you for this day that we have anticipated for so long, and we thank you that it's finally here. We thank you for this union of marriage that they have decided to join together as one, oh God. So we come right now praying you will be with us in this wedding ceremony, oh God. We thank you that we can feel your presence. We thank you that we can feel your love. We thank you that we can feel your joy and your peace. So God, continue to be with us and stand by us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.
The home is built upon love, which virtue is best portrayed in the 13th chapter of Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. So faith, hope, love, abide these three. But the greatest of these is love. And I believe that Enwa and Kimbrell have written their vows. And at this time, I'm going to ask Enwa to give his vows to his soon-to-be bride. Yes. Her vows to the groom.
dedicate my life to our foundation and what our love means to one another. You are every reason why I am the woman I am today, and I promise to always give you the assurance that you will always be my first priority when I wake up and when I go to sleep. As I carry your name, I will be the representation of what a wife and a mother is supposed to be: warm, welcoming, comforting. I will follow your lead for the rest of my life and be the wife God designed me to be just for you. I love you.
Will you take Kimbrell to be your wife? Will you commit yourself to her happiness and her self-fulfillment as a person and to her usefulness in God's kingdom? And will you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve her in sickness and in health, in adversity and in prosperity, and to be true and loyal to her so long as you both shall live? Kimbrell, will you take Inwar to be your husband? Will you commit yourself to his happiness and his self-fulfillment as a person and to his usefulness in God's kingdom? And do you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve him in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him so long as you both shall live? Amen. Now, you all have wedding rings.
Yeah, both of them.
All right. The wedding ring is a symbol of marriage in at least two ways. The purity of gold symbolizes the purity of your love for each other, and the unending circle symbolizes the unending vows which you all are taking, which may be broken honorably in the sight of God only by death. As a token of your vows, you will give and receive the rings. These are heavy rings. And Inwa, will you repeat after me? You repeat after me. Kimbrell, with this ring, I pledge my life and love to you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Kimbrell, will you repeat after me? Inwa, with this ring, I pledge my love and life to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, you all may exchange your rings. Let's go to God and pray. I'm going to ask if you all would just extend your right hand and join me in prayer. Oh Lord, our Lord, how amazing, how awesome, how excellent is your name in all the earth. We come right now just giving you thanks for this day, the day that you've known way before these two were even born, oh God. The day that you have divinely orchestrated that day on the Tiger Walk at Texas Southern University, that these two would become one. So God, we thank you that this is a marriage that will be an example of your godly love. We thank you that this will be a marriage that will be able to transcend what generations may have said that they would never be able to do, oh God. So God, we come right now lifting up Inwa and Kimbrell before you, dear Father. We know that they are going to need you, God. So we come right now lifting them up before you and believing right now by faith that they will be a strong couple, that they will be a godly couple, that they will depend on each other, oh God, that they will be equally yoked, that when one is down, they both will be down, that when one is up, they both will be up, oh God. So God, we come right now coming against anything that may try to hinder them from being all that you have called them to be. So God, we pray right now that you would order their steps. Lead them and guide them in the direction it is that you would have them to go, oh God. We come right now praying you will break every generational curse that may be trying to come against them. That you will bring up generational wealth in them, oh God. That you will have them to raise their children in a healthy and a wholesome household, oh God. In a godly household, oh God. So God, we come right now thanking you for this marriage. We thank you for these two that have shown their commitment to you. So God, we pray right now that in the days, in the weeks, and in the years to come, when they need you, oh God, that they will be able to call on you. But God, help them know that they have a support system that's rooting for them, that's cheering them on, oh God. And when they can't call on you, we have a God that is able and accessible at all times. And we pray right now that in the time of need, they will learn to call on the name of Jesus. So God, we come right now, believing right now by faith, that they will be the head and not the tail. They shall be above and not beneath. They shall be lenders and not borrowers. So God, in the name of Jesus, we pray right now that you will cover them from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. That everything that they stand in need of, that you will provide for them, oh God. Whether it's finances, oh God. Whether it's support, oh God. Whether it's love, that you will give it to them right now in the name of Jesus. So God, we come right now thanking you that you will be the glue that keeps them together. So God, if people may try to break them up, if things may try to break them up, if situations may try to break them up, help them to look to the hills of which cometh their help. And help them and let them know that all of their help comes from you, O God. We thank you that you are God that can do all things. You sit high and you look low. You can do all things, O God. There's one thing that you cannot do, and you cannot fail. Amen. So God, we come right now thanking for this marriage that will not fail. Because this is a marriage that will be rooted in you. This is a marriage that will be grounded in you. This is a marriage that is going to have their firm foundation standing on you, oh God. So God, in every day that they will be able to know how to call on you, if they're not getting by because of some self-help book or by some wedding book or some marriage counseling book, oh God, but they're making it every day because they're going to trust and depend on you. So God, we come right now giving you all the praise. We come right now giving you all the glory, and we come right now giving you all the honor for the great things that you are going to do in their lives. For we believe that eyes have not seen, and ears have not heard, and neither has entered into the hearts of people the great things that you are going to do in Ewald's and Kim Burrell's life. So we give you the praise, the glory, and the honor, and we seal this prayer in the name that's above every name, in the name that's able to make sick bodies be healed, in the name that's able to make demons tremble, oh God, in the name of the one who's able to heal and did not even go around to be the first to announce Mr. and Mrs. Ewald Dino Fernandez.
Thank you. I'd like to introduce to y'all Mr. and Mrs. Fernandez.
Thank you. the color that I take when you let loose. You're the sunshine of my life. I just want to see how beautiful you are. You know that I see. I know you're a star. Where you go, I follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, then you're the
y'all give it up for Mr. and Mrs. Fernandez.
First off, I want to thank everybody who came out today to celebrate Mr. and Mrs. Fernandez.
Yes.
You know, whether you know it or not, big girl, you are a big part of who I am today. You set a perfect example of someone who is honest, hardworking, and amazing, and now a husband. You know who I, you know what? I have a story for y'all, but I'm not going to dare you today, okay? Just know, yeah. What I do want you to know, when you leave here tonight, remembering that every last one of us appreciate you, and who you are to us. I love you, bro, and you know, we're locked in forever. And before I go, congrats, I want you to know that we appreciate you, well, sis, for being an amazing woman, a mother, and now a wife. Just in case you thought, we are the wife, we are locked in forever as well. Love you, sis.
Father-daughter dance. Y'all give it up for the band and the mama dance. Alright. We're gonna keep the party rolling. Y'all give it up for the mother and son dance. All right, next, we have the son and the grandmother dance. Once again, y'all. Single man and woman at Taco Garden. All right.